Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, fight fans. Welcome back. Is Jermall Charlo more dangerous than Caleb Plant? Look, let's just break it down honestly and objectively. And we start with David Benavidez. And David Benavidez, in a recent interview, stated that, "I think Charlo would be more of a dangerous fight than Caleb Plant because he has a lot more experience and I feel like he has a lot more power. I feel like Caleb Plant belongs at 160 pounds. He doesn't belong at 168. He's fought such weak opposition. He's fought Mike Lee after he won the belt, and then he fought Fine Butts after that. So they gave him two extremely weak opponents. I feel like Charlo would be a harder opponent, but I feel like I'd beat him too. I think it would be way more exciting fight with Charlo because we'd both be looking for the knockout." And that's a direct quote from David Benavidez. And you know, he just doesn't rate Caleb Plant that highly at all. And look, let's just break it down. Is he more, you know, dangerous than Jermall Charlo? Is Jermall Charlo more dangerous than Caleb Plant? And both of these guys have two different styles, but both of these guys, you know, they stack up and rank differently. So let's just break it down. And when you look at both of these guys, you start, you know, with Caleb Plant. He's in his prime. He's 6'1" and he has a 74-inch reach. Then when you look at Jermall Charlo, he's 6 foot with a 73.5-inch reach, and he's also in his prime. So these guys are both guys who are in their prime. These are both guys that are both undefeated, and both of these guys are about the same size and have about the same reach. It's very, very close. So these guys have a lot of the, you know, dimensions very, very similar. Not only that, you look at it that neither one of these guys have been tested at the elite level. So, you know, we really don't know how good or bad either one of these guys truly is because neither one of these guys have ever fought top level competition in either of their respective divisions. So when you look at Jermall Charlo, for example, you see that Jermall Charlo seemed to have a power advantage over Caleb Plant. He seemed to show throughout his career that he's been a pretty good power puncher. He seemed to be effective at power punching the opponents he has faced. But then on a reverse end, you see that, you know, Caleb Plant, he's been a much better boxer than Jermall Charlo. He's been better at, you know, defensively, moving his head, moving his body, setting up shots, countering his opponents. So Caleb Plant has shown that he has better overall boxing ability than Jermall Charlo. And then on the other hand, you see that Jermall Charlo was cleanly and smoothly outboxed by, you know, Matt Korobov. After he was outboxed by Matt Korobov, we kind of understood exactly where Jermall Charlo ranked, exactly where he belongs, exactly who he is. Because, you know, a lot of people felt like he lost that fight against Matt Korobov. Matt Korobov is not an elite level boxer, but we know how good Matt Korobov is, and he's just not at the top level. On the other end, we see Caleb Plant has never been anywhere near an opponent as good as a Matt Korobov, and that's not saying much at all. You know, you see Caleb Plant outboxing guys like Fine Butts, which actually means absolutely nothing. Guys like Mike Lee, which absolutely means nothing. You know, I think Danny Jacobs and David Benavidez, two of their, you know, contemporaries at the same weight at 168, both state that, you know, Caleb Plant hasn't been tested. They see a lot of flaws and they think he's the weakest champion at 168. So, you know, to break it down, who's more dangerous, Jermall Charlo or Caleb Plant? I think, you know, when you look at these guys, they're both equal. You know, they have about the same risk level, but for different reasons. I think Caleb Plant's more dangerous than Jermall Charlo to outbox an opponent. I think Jermall Charlo's more dangerous to hurt an opponent. So I think both of these guys have their own advantages. I think Jermall Charlo is obviously more of a puncher, and Caleb Plant is obviously more of a boxer. And, you know, whoever is on that night is going to win the fight, because I can see Charlo being outboxed, and I can see Caleb Plant being hurt. You know, you can see both guys taking advantage of the other guy's weaknesses. And, you know, even when they fight other guys at the 168-pound division, you could see that happening. You could see one of these guys, you know, performing well in one way rather than the other. You know, Caleb Plant doesn't have a lot of power for 168, at least it doesn't appear that way. And then you also see Jermall Charlo at the same time, you know, he doesn't really even have elite skills boxing wise, you know. at 160 pounds, and he's talking about moving to 168. So, you know, I think David Benavidez beats both of these guys cleanly, clearly, and concisely. I think neither one of these guys are a match for a guy like David Benavidez. He's too big, too strong, too relentless, and presents too much pressure. But I think both of these guys represent an equal amount of a threat, but for different reasons altogether. One is boxing, and one is just a big punch. But once again, unbiased as always, is the IBFP.